Hello, you're in time for the handshake here on New Vision TV with me, Lynn Komjisha. I'm joined by Paul Busherizi. Paul, welcome to the show.
Thank you.
So 38.8% of businesses in Uganda are owned by women. Yay! Yeah, I'm a woman.
Okay.
I'm supposed to rejoice on their behalf. Okay. So, what does this mean for us?
No, it's. I think that figure came out of a study that was done by MasterCard, and they're looking at women entrepreneurs around the world. Mm-hmm. Uganda actually has the third highest.
It was third
business.
Yes.
In the world.
Yes.
Behind Russia and
Ghana.
Ghana and
The other was I forget it. We'll get it.
Yes, Ghana was I think at the Botswana maybe or something.
Mm.
So 38% of businesses, that means one in every three businesses is owned by a woman. It's a good thing.
Mm-hmm.
We know that we talk about it all the time, you know, and it's the reason behind the campaign to educate women, that the more women are empowered in terms of financially and the ability to look after themselves, self-reliance,
yes. Mm-hmm.
The better families are generally.
True.
Know that women focus a lot more on their families than men do.
That's true.
If you have an empowered woman in the family, mother, mother and maybe her daughters as well, it's a good thing. So it's something to actually cheer.
Yes. Earlier. Yes, but there's some MP who said they should discipline their women. I don't know how they'll do that if they want to achieve a lot of things. Now, Paul, that was a by the way. Paul, with this... in Uganda, I wonder, they're saying that 38.8%, but are these formal businesses or these are just, normal businesses?
Well, I'm sure it was a percentage of all the businesses, formal and informal.
Okay.
And it's not a bad thing, even if they're informal, because actually all businesses start as informal businesses.
Yeah, true.
You know, all businesses start as the thought in the head of somebody, and you know, it starts by selling outside, in many cases outside, even before being registered.
Mm.
So it's not a bad thing, it's a good thing. I think the challenge is, can we move these things, more of them, into the formal sector and make them grow and be strong companies that create jobs and even export.
What does us being third best globally mean for Uganda? Does this mean that the government is going to look more into women issues and women businesses? You know, they usually come in to help businesses that are struggling.
Well, first of all, we take it for granted in Uganda.
Yeah.
But there are many countries in the world where starting a business is not a normal thing to do.
Sure.
Because people maybe are comfortable in their jobs,
mm-hmm.
and things. Our history of entrepreneurship comes from, you know, the hard days we had in the 70s and the 80s when a job couldn't
sustain you.
Couldn't sustain you, so you needed to do something else. So. The mere fact that we have the spirit of entrepreneurship,
mm-hmm.
and it's not, you know, it's not abnormal. We know. We take it for granted. We know.
It's
not abnormal in Uganda. For somebody say, I'm doing something on the side.
Mm-hmm.
You'll be shocked. You go to countries and say, what are you doing? I'm doing something on the side. I'm doing my job.
Mm-hmm.
So that in itself is an advantage, because businesses are what create jobs.
Yeah.
Governments do not create. Governments only create the environment for jobs to be created. But governments...
True.
Don't create jobs, it's businesses.
Mm.
So, and we know that around the world, only about maybe 1 in 10 companies survive to their fifth birthday.
Mm-hmm.
It's almost a universal statistic.
Yeah.
So it therefore follows that if you have more and more businesses being created,
mm-hmm.
that means more and more will survive.
Yes.
So you're better in a country like Uganda, which is producing 1,000 businesses a day, than
mm-hmm.
a country which is producing 10 businesses a day.
A day, yeah.
Because if only 1 in 10 survives, and here we'll have 100 surviving,
mm-hmm.
you're good. So it's a fantastic thing. We just have to harness this energy, because that's what it is.
Yeah, harness the energy. What could be the challenges these women face? And I'm sure they're not the only ones.
Mm. I think the report mentioned it, the challenges that women face are the same, more or less, like the ones any small business faces. Of course, women have the added challenge of being women.
Yeah.
Interestingly, in that survey, it showed that there are certain countries where, like Portugal, where woman-owned business is just an anomaly. In Uganda, we see everyone, it's normal. So women of Uganda have the, you know, kind of moved beyond that challenge of being their business looked down. So like any other business, they need to formalize.
Right.
First of all, they need to get their books in order. They need to work towards building these businesses, not only keeping them small. People say, why should I build a business? When you build a business, you increase your chance of survival. And that's what we want. We want businesses to survive.
To survive, yes.
So the aspiration has to be, I want a bigger and bigger and bigger business.
True.
And the growth of the business is only as good as how formal it is. Beyond a certain size, you can't keep taking and putting in your pocket and wondering at the end of the day, how much do I have?
Yeah.
You actually have structured it. So I think, you know, as a bare minimum, I think even the women of Uganda, the business women of Uganda, they need to aspire to having more formal businesses, bigger businesses.
Right. Wow.
It makes life easier. It allows you to grow and makes life easier, like raising finance.
It also makes families, you know, grow. Yeah.
I don't know about you. See, if it's a man's business, when the business grows, you go and marry other women. I don't know about women.
That's it.
No, women don't get more children.
I'm not meaning family in terms of more kids and more people in the home. I mean growth.
The quality of
the quality, yes. The living standards.
Absolutely.
Because, you know,
kids
women
go to
are
better
very.
Schools.
Yeah, you know.
They dress better, they feed better, which is fantastic. Yes, absolutely.
Which helps a lot.
I think it's a very. Promising, can you call it promising or good thing?
Yes.
That women are so engaged in Uganda. In
yeah, right. Ah, amazing. Thank you so much, Paul. That makes
welcome.
Me very, very happy. Yeah, about women.